Hi, this is Kira McKee, the scientist videographer, and this is a review of the Phantom 2 Quadcopter, an aerial drone sold by DJI. I had an opportunity recently to go out with some colleagues who are planning to use this drone in their scientific research and consulting. So let's take a closer look. The drone was field tested in a coastal environment in South Louisiana along the Gulf of Mexico. And here you see the quadcopter taking off for the first flight. And in this view, you can see the camera shooting a 360-degree pan at an altitude of about 350 feet. The FAA restricts remotely operated drones to 400 feet to avoid aircraft. This drone also has a warning system that prevents operation near airports. And as you can see, one of the fantastic features of these quadcopters is the ability to hover in position with little or no vibration. And as you'll see, the drone will allow you to shoot really smooth video footage.
Well, we purchased the drone because we regularly do research at a number of field sites that are both marsh and beach sites that are relatively remote. And although we regularly use aerial imagery or downlooking aerial imagery to get a view of these sites, what we'd often like to have is a little bit different perspective at lower altitude or at angle so that we can better identify the vegetation in the area, the densities of the vegetation, the type of changes that we'll see on the beach. And the drones seem to be a good tool to be able to do this.
The quadcopter is relatively small and lightweight, only a couple of pounds. And this one was equipped with a GoPro Hero 3 Black Edition camera, which can shoot spectacular action film. The drone is operated with a remote control console and monitor that shows real-time video from the camera. It's powered by a battery that is good for about 20 minutes of flying time. The video footage looks like it was shot from a crane dolly or some other professional setup because the camera is on a gimbal that produces these smooth gliding images. Although the top speed is 15 meters per second, this is not recommended. You will get better footage by moving slowly and carefully. Notice how well the drone hovers, even in the wind. And the angle of the camera can be changed from forward-looking to vertical while in flight. If communication is lost, there is a fail-safe system that is supposed to return the drone to its starting position. The imagery is saved to a micro SD card and can be immediately reviewed on a computer. We next experimented with running the drone manually along a marked transect across the marsh, which seemed to work well. It's also possible to program the drone via GPS to follow a prearranged flight path. For this trial, however, the drone was flown manually, about 6 meters or 20 feet off the ground.
We're just learning about all the different things that we can do with the drone, but certainly we have many other sites that are similar to the one we shot today, which is a marsh site down in South Louisiana, and a number of beach sites that are also offshore of this area, and we're going to use the drone in a number of these sites to again better understand the changes in geomorphology along the beach as it evolves through seasons of the year, and also the vegetation types and densities that exist in various marsh sites, both from freshwater on down into saltwater marshes.
The quadcopter was really a lot of fun to watch. It performed extremely well and was easy to fly with some practice. Of course, we had an experienced pilot operating the drone. Everyone in our group was impressed and excited about the possibilities for its use in field research. We also tried a night flight in our hotel parking lot, which produced surprisingly good footage.
Yeah.
We have 10 satellites now. We're pretty doing good there.
So you just flipped it down to the vertical.
Then I go straight up, I think,
Well, that's a brief look at the Phantom 2 quadcopter. You can read my detailed comments about the drone on my blog. This is Kara McKee, the scientist videographer. Thanks for watching.